Rodgers down on first down. Look out, Rodgers lost the football. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back, but it will be a loss on the play. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Now Rodgers rolling on second down. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. He's got his targets caught. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Rodgers to Cobb, good for a Green Bay first. Now Rodgers, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And I think the Bears have recovered. They have. And I don't know that that fumble's going to matter a whole lot. You look at the deficit here in the fourth. It doesn't matter. The coach on the sideline still scratching his head.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing a note or two about, we're going to address this come practice next week because maybe that's the reason we're down this far. Doesn't matter at this point, but being sloppy throughout the game, not going to help them improve.
And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. Chased out left. And that is incomplete. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target. And that bring up second down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Let's go! Now we'll look to throw here on second and 10. Flush to his right. A strong running. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Clay Matthews in there to drop him for a loss on the play.
Brandon, that's just football 101. If you're out of the pocket, you've got to get rid of the football in this situation. You cannot take a sack in a two-minute drill.
The first throw now from the backup, Roethlisberger. Man, it's Vernon Davis. That one goes for 24 yards.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. Here, I'm Brandon Gunn alongside Charles Davis, so the offense takes the timeout, and now we're set to get going. The Bears on third down, they've been outstanding, 7 first downs and 8 tries. This is going to be 3rd and 13. For the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Going for it all. And this will be caught. We're taking the knee. Some late gamesmanship here as they throw for a late touchdown. I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle. I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know it was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. They had, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
It's up and good, and they add one more to what will wind up a fairly lopsided victory. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.